Well, hello, vinyl community. Elliot here, Lazy Dawg's Records. And there's a great thread going around called the Jazz Label Challenge. It's being put on by the Jazz Bums. If you're not familiar with the Jazz Bums, Chris, Mike, and Felipe, a great channel. They do some live streaming. They do lots of videos a lot. It's the three of them discussing jazz and related topics. And they've got, all the three have great personalities, full of great information. And so if you're not subscribed to them, I highly recommend it. That's the Jazz Bums. I'll put a link down below. Now, so the challenge speaks for itself, Jazz Label Challenge. They want us to show five albums from five different labels. They give us four labels, and we select one more album from a label not in the list. So I'll work my way through in more or less chronological order of the release of the albums. Now, this first artist is on Riverside, and, you know, maybe he's not, you know, up there highly regarded by the jazz snobs, maybe, I don't know, but because he's kind of he was popular, you know, so that kind of gets the snobs you know, to give you a thumbs down. But most of us aren't snobs, I don't think. And I really like Charlie Bird, the guitarist, and this is Bossa Nova by the Birds, and they write it out in Portuguese here, Bossa Nova by the Birds. And it says it contains the hit single Meditation, comes from 1962. And I really enjoy Charlie Bird. And if I'm not mistaken, he's one of the artists that brought Bossa Nova over to the United States after traveling into South America and hearing it performed and learning about it. So it's on the Riverside label. There we go. Let's get close. Nice label, and it says it's micro groove, which means even from a 1962, which makes it what, 60 years old, it still plays pretty darn good. And this is one I just found in, you know, for 50 cents or a buck in a thrift store somewhere. Charlie Bird. And great, he had a series of these albums in the early 60s, several of them featuring various birds, parakeets and toucans and whatnot. Okay. Next, from 1969, I'll show you a Riverside Riverside. I'll show you a Blue Note. I didn't want to show you, a Blue Note that we would kind of expect to see, you know, Lee Morgan or Horace Silver or something like that. I wanted to show something that that might not see that often. It's from 1969. It's a compilation, Blue Notes, Three Decades of Jazz, 30th anniversary commemorative. And again, picked this up. I think I got this at a record show, actually, not a thrift shop. This one I got from a thrift shop. And, you know, for next to nothing, Blue Note Records. And Liberty was distributing them back then. And this has music, as I said, going from 1959 to 1969. And it's got stuff from Eric Dolphy and Horace Silver, Stanley Turrentine, Ornette Coleman Trio, Lou Donaldson, Ike Quebec, Jimmy Smith, Kenny Burrell, Lee Morgan, and Donald Byrd. So the artists that you think of on Blue Note, but you get one or two songs from each of them. So, you know, it's kind of a good thing to say, oh, because I don't know that I want to go out and buy a whole album of Ornette Coleman Trio, knowing that he's free jazz. I don't know if I would like it or not, but to listen to this, maybe I would have a better idea and could make a better decision. So that's my Blue Note. Oh, since it's a Blue Note, we probably want to see it. This was back when, I guess Liberty owned the Blue Note label for a while. And, kind of a lighter blue than I'm used to seeing on Blue Note. And get this back in here, and then we'll see what our next one is. I love resurrecting records. You know, this and some of the others I'm going to show you, the jackets are in rough shape, but you do not play the jacket. So if the vinyl's in good shape, then it's, and especially if it's marked down a lot because the jacket's in bad shape, then it's a really great deal. Okay, from I think 1972, I believe, on Prestige Records. Most of my Prestige was blues, so I didn't have much jazz. And this is kind of a intersection of blues and jazz. Moe's Allison, and it's Allison. This is a twofer on Prestige. And I don't know, it was remastered by Rudy Van Gelder. So there's that. But and Fantasy and Prestige were the same, right? There's the original inner sleeve. Moe's Allison. And I actually had Moe's in my blues section, went looking for it in jazz and it wasn't there. So I did shift it over, and I have two Moe's Allison albums. So one of them is much more blues and one's much more jazz. Got to put them all somewhere because I have my records by genre. And so I put them in jazz since I'm doing the jazz label challenge. All right. 1973, but actually recorded in 1968. Impulse, owned by ABC Records, is our next. And it's Ahmad Jamal, Tranquility. And you see, once again, I find records that look bad, but they just need a little loving, a little taken care of, a little tender loving care. I don't know much about Ahmad Jamal, piano player, and this is a trio, piano, bass, and drums. This album was actually done, I don't know if this is a reissue, it was recorded in 68, and this came out in 73, so I don't know if it's a reissue, actually originally came out in 68, but this was done as a quadraphonic recording. Okay, so there's my Impulse. And my last one is where I picked the label, is one of my favorite record labels out of Chicago, not known for its jazz so much, much more known for its acoustic roots type music, bluegrass and old time and folk. And but they record some jazz, and in this case, they definitely did. Swonderful, Four Giants of Swing, this one's called, and on Flying Fish Records, there's the flying fish symbol, and that's what's playing right now, actually. This recording has a, listen to that beautiful violin. I don't know how you pronounce it, Joe Venuti. The jazz violinist. Curly Chalker on steel guitar. Eldon Shamblin on electric guitar. These two, let's see, these two were with Bob Wills and the Texas Playboys playing that Western Swing, which is a form of jazz, again, a swing type jazz. And the artist that I know best is right here, Mr. Jeffro Burns. You might know him better, if you're not familiar with Jeffro Burns, as one half of the comedy parody music duo Homer and Jeffro. They had success in the early 60s, late 50s, I guess, early 60s and on into the 60s with a kind of novelty act. But in reality, Jeffro is an outstanding jazz mandolinist. That is his main instrument, mandolin. And I think he stayed in the Chicago area because I know he played with some of the singer-songwriters back in the 70s, like Steve Goodman, singer-songwriter, and John Prine. And he played a lot of jazz as well. He had some solo albums. Swing jazz is what he plays, and that's what's playing here. This is the Four Giants of Swing, Swanderful, they called themselves for this album. And side one is almost all Duke Ellington tunes. One is a Strayhorn tune, so still from that same venue, that same feel. And side two is almost all Gershwin, although they do Caravan as the last song on side two, the Duke Ellington song. So this goes to show you don't really think of steel guitar as being a jazz instrument. That's the thing about jazz. It's open to most any instrumentation that you just play in the jazz style. So those are my jazz label challenge recordings I wanted to share with you. And I'll close it out by just reminding everybody to be kind to your neighbors, folks, because we're all neighbors.